62:6-7, and today's title is Rock Him. Psalm 62, beginning at verse 6, it says, He only is my rock and my salvation. He is my defense. I shall not be moved. In God is my salvation and my glory. The rock of my strength and my refuge is in God. Amen. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, we're here to give you thanks and glory. We're here to lift you up. We're here to just thank you and give you awesome glory, Father, and magnify your name today. Fill us up with your Holy Spirit. Fill us up with your wisdom and understanding. Hide this preacher behind the cross. And let it be you that is seen and only you that is heard. And we ask all these things in the name above all names, the name of Jesus. You may be seated. Amen.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. This verse says that he is my rock of my salvation. Amen. He is my defense. He is my strength. I shall not be moved. He is my refuge. He is my God. Hallelujah. That's right. Psalm 89:26 says, you are my Father, my God, and the rock of my salvation. Amen. When the enemy comes, I'm going to rock him. Amen. That's right. I'm going to attack him with the rock of my salvation, with the rock of my defense, with the rock of my strength. Amen? Amen. That's right. When you are attacked by the enemy, you need to take proper steps to address that threat. Amen. Amen. When you're being attacked and the enemy comes up against you, you need to take proper steps to attack that attack. Amen. Are you ready for the attacks of the enemy? Are you prepared? Because the enemy will attack. So you need to be ready for the enemy's attack. And you need to be prepared for when the enemy does attack. Because the Bible says that he will attack you. Amen. 1 Peter 5:8 says, for your adversary, the devil, prowls about like a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. The enemy is seeking someone to attack. And the Bible calls that he comes at you like a roaring lion. You ever seen a lion out in the jungle? You ever notice the people he attacks? He attacks the ones that pull away from the crowd, that hang back all by themselves. Or the weaker animals that aren't too strong, that kind of get isolated by themselves. The enemy just loves attacking those. He don't attack the strong and the healthy because they move too fast. They can run, they can hide, they can leap and jump. So he waits to attack those who are sleeping, those who are not paying attention, those who feel like they're hurting or sick or feeling down. And you start thinking on this stuff and you're just the perfect prey for the devil. Amen. You're not paying attention. You're not with the crowd that follow Christ. You're not involved in a church where people, you know, pray for each other. You're off alone by yourself, an island. Amen. I can do it by myself. I don't need church. I can do it. Well, you're isolated. You're by yourself. The devil is waiting to attack you. That is why when the enemy attacks, you must be ready because he is out to attack you. Amen. You must respond to the enemy with the rock. Amen. When the devil comes at you, you gotta rock him. You gotta hit him. Amen. With the rock of your salvation, with the rock of your defense, with the rock of your strength. Amen. And the best place to fight the devil is on his ground. Amen. Take the fight to him. Don't wait till he brings the fight to you. Amen. The Bible right here, we read, it says that the Lord is my defense and I shall not be moved. Amen. That means that when the devil attacks me, I'm not to move back at all. I'm not to give one inch to the devil. So when the devil attacks me, I'm not going to move back. I ain't gonna give them inches. I ain't gonna give them feet. I'm not gonna give them yards. I'm not gonna move. Amen? Amen. Ephesians 4:27 says, getting a little too excited here. Oh. Woo! Yeah. It's coming, baby. Ephesians 4:27 says, give no place to the devil. That means don't give the devil any place on your ground. Don't fight the devil on your territory. Amen? Fight him on his ground. Take the fight to him. Move in on his ground. Take territory from the devil. Amen? Sometimes we wait until the devil attacks us and we're fighting the devil, but we're fighting him on our own ground. Well, we got to take the fight to the devil and fight him on his ground. And as we take the fight to the devil on his ground, we're stealing that ground back from the devil that he's already stole from us. Amen. Fight him on his ground. Fight him on his territory. 1 Chronicles 4:10 says, Jabez called on the God of Israel, saying, oh, that you would bless me indeed and enlarge my territory, that your hand would be with me, and that you would keep me from the evil one. And so God granted him his request. The devil is trying to move into your territory. He's trying to steal ground from you. Trying to steal ground from your marriage, from your relationships, from your family, from your body, from your business. Amen. You need to ask the Lord to bless you indeed and to increase your territory. But at the same time, you got to know that God has already granted you the territory you want. It's already yours. We ask him, but knowing that he's already given it to us. He's granted us the territory to enlarge our territory in need. Amen? That's right. You need to get him to enlarge it, but yet at the same time, you need to know that he's already done it. That territory is already yours. It's yours right now. But the enemy is not going to release it without a fight. The enemy knows it's yours. And he's counting on you not knowing it's yours. Amen? It's already yours, but he's holding it. And he's not going to give it up that easy. He ain't going to get scared that easy. He's going to hold it until you fight for it. Amen. Until you attack the devil. Amen? Amen. With the rock of my salvation. Amen? Amen? That's right. The devil ain't going to give it up easily. And that's why you got to take it by force. No more playing around with the devil. I'm tired of the devil, amen? Yeah. I ain't taking it no more. I'm pushing him back. I'm sticking my finger in his chest. I'm blacking his eye. I'm kicking him in the butt to get on. Ooh, I was the wrong thing, boy. Amen. Kick him where it counts, see? That's right. Get him to run. Matthew 11:12 says, From the day of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven has suffered violence. But the violent man takes it by force. This is talking about us. The devil can't take nothing by force, amen? He's talking about the violent man takes it by force. Think about that for a minute. We are in the kingdom of God, and we are suffering violence from the unseen enemy. Daily, he's constantly attacking us violently. Amen? Yeah. That's right, from the unseen foe. But the violent take it by force. That tells me that I gotta attack fire with fire. He's coming at me violently. I gotta attack back violently. Amen? And people will be like, well, I don't know. Violent sounds kind of negative. Is that of God? Is that of God? Amen? We're getting a violently attacked in our health, in our marriage, in our children, in our business. Yes, we need to violently attack back. We got to rock him. And again, people will be like, violence sounds negative. Aren't we supposed to love and do all that? Yeah. Yeah, the people of God, not the enemy. Amen? That's right. God had promised the children of Israel that he would give them a land flowing with milk and honey. And God gave them that promise, but they had to go in there and take it violently. Amen. They had to go in there and kill them. Amen. Defeat the enemy with violence. You can't defeat the enemy if you don't get violent with them. Amen. Just think about when somebody comes and attacks you, a human being. You get so mad, you attack them back, right? Well, it's the same thing. When the devil attacks you, why ain't we attacking him back? If I stood up against you and opposed you, you would attack me. Amen? Amen?
Amen.
You would shove me around, get out of my face, preacher, don't be telling me that, and I get violently struck. How about when the devil comes at you? We don't say a word. Are we afraid of him? Are we scared? No, man. We got the rock of our salvation. The rock of our defense. The rock of my strength. And I'm going to rock him. Amen? That's right. That's right. They had to attack the enemy and drive the enemy out before they could even possess the land. Right now, you got promises of God, and the devil ain't going to release them to you unless you violently take it. Amen. You got to come at them with the power of the Lord, with the rock in your hand, and just start smashing on that devil. Making him back up. Move the line forward. Gain ground from him. The line's here, I'm going there. Then next week, no more. And each time, I'm pushing him further and further back off. I ain't going to wait till he's on my ground. Wrestle with him on my territory. No way. I'm going to take the Lord be with me. Is this of you? And then God's involved, and then the devil's out. But sometimes we do stuff, and then after we're involved in stuff, then we're like, Lord, help me out. See, now the devil's fighting you on your ground. But I'm going to keep that devil at bay, amen. I'm going to push him back. I'm going to holler. I'm going to shoot, pollute, whatever I need to do. The same way he's attacking me, I'm attacking him. Ain't no mercy with the devil. And I'm definitely ain't going to have no mercy on the devil. Amen? Amen? That's right, brothers and sisters. Are you tired this morning of the devil getting involved up in your business? Tired of the enemy all up in your home, at work, and at play? Just messing with you, stirring problems up, creating chaos, creating confusion, creating deceit and deception? If you are tired, then you got to get angry. You gotta get aggressive. You gotta get mean. You gotta get violent. You gotta go on attack mode and start rocking that devil. Amen? Start rocking him. Hallelujah to Jesus. We are talking about violently attacking our enemy, the devil, and his kingdom. Amen. Now, I'm not talking about attacking people who are filled with the devil. Amen? Yeah, because we're like, the preacher said attack. This must be of the devil. Pop! No, we attack the devil that they're filled with. Amen? That's right, brothers and sisters. We gotta attack that devil. And again, we don't attack the people who are full of it. But at the same time, if there's somebody in your life who's bringing the devil into your business, who's bringing the devil into your house, who's bringing the devil into your relationship, then you got to cast him out. Doesn't mean you beat him up and attack him, but you got to somehow get rid of that evil spirit. Amen? That's right, because Psalms 1 says, blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly. If you got somebody hanging around in your business, in your play, in your home, who's constantly counseling for the devil, he's got to go. If he's causing problems, he's got to go. Amen? It says, nor stands in the path of sinners. Or somebody, you can't stand with them if they're against you. Amen? You're bringing them into your house and you're standing in agreement with them because you don't want to cut that person off. Then you're welcoming the devil in your house. Amen? I'm not saying beat them up, sock them up, knee them, kick them, floor them. I'm saying he's got to go. Somehow, you got to find that person. Got to go. Amen? And then it says, nor sits in the seat of the scornful. People in your life that are mocking God, that laugh at God, that laugh at our testimony, they gotta go. If they ain't lining up, they gotta go. And that's how you get the devil out of your life. You're attacking the devil. You're not attacking that person. You're like, I love you, man, but you keep bringing the devil with you. You gotta go. I love you from a distance. Bye-bye. Amen? That's right. If they're dead set in their way, then I can't help you. You know what I mean? I can't do nothing for you until you come to Jesus. So I can't be around you. I can see you all wave high. We'll slap hands, but we ain't kicking it. You're bringing the devil with you. And I can't have that. Amen? That's right, brothers and sisters. Ephesians 6:12 says, for we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against rulers of the dark age, against spiritual hosts of wickedness in high places. So you see, we are not at war with flesh and blood, meaning we're not wrestling with people. We are wrestling with spiritual wickedness. And the way you attack spiritual wickedness is with spiritual righteousness. Amen? With spiritual truth. Amen? You don't fight the enemy in the flesh. You fight him on a spiritual level. You come at him with faith, and you fight him with the sword that comes out of your mouth. Amen? Those two things, faith and your mouth. Because faith doesn't do nothing until you start speaking it out. Amen? You start speaking to that devil, I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. Flee, you cur. Amen? You are a defeated foe. Jesus has crushed your head. Verses of the Bible. You don't have to say them exactly how it is, but you know it says that. Jesus has crushed your head. Get behind me, Satan. Amen? I have authority over you. You don't need to quote the whole verse. Just know that that's what God said. Amen? 2 Corinthians. 2 Corinthians 10:4, for the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty in God, for the pulling down of strongholds. Amen? Amen. A stronghold is when the enemy moves into your territory and sets up shop there, and now he won't go, he won't leave, he will not budge. He's got a stronghold in your life. Maybe in your business, in your marriage, in your relationships, or in your house, somewhere. He moves in into your territory, and now he will not leave. And the only way you can get someone that will not leave your house is you got to get violent. You got to pick them up and throw them out. Amen. If you tell somebody constantly, get out, get out, get out, and they won't get out of your house, I know most of you would be like, that's it. Well, that's how you got to get, amen? The only way to get him to go is you got to get aggressive, you got to get angry, you got to get mean, and you violently got to lead him out. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. The weapons you have to do this, they're not carnal. They're not knives, guns, bombs, rockets, or physical force. Your weapons are mighty in God. Amen? Amen. You have spiritual weapons. You have spiritual armor. When you accepted Jesus as Lord and Savior, he equipped you with weapons and armor to rock the enemy.
Amen.
Right now you are fully equipped. Amen. Ephesians 6:10 says, finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. You have been given the armor of God. You have the armor of God right now, but you have to put it on. Amen? It's already there. All the power to defeat the enemy is already yours. You got weapons. You got armory. You got everything you need to go forward and push that devil back. Amen? That's right, Ephesians 6:13. Therefore, take up the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand in the day of evil. Hallelujah, you have the breastplate of truth. You have the belt of truth, the breastplate of righteousness, the boots of the gospel, the shield of faith, and the helmet of salvation. God has given you the armor to protect you from the enemy. You notice that all the armory is in front of you? The helmet, the shield, the breastplate, the belt, the shoes, nothing to protect your back. Because you're not supposed to turn back. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You're supposed to go forward. If you turn back with this armor, your back's going to be exposed. And that's when the devil gets you. That's when the devil sinks his claws into your back. We're not supposed to turn back. For the armor is only there to protect your front. Because why? Jesus has got your back. Amen.
Yeah.
And he's giving you the tools to go forward head on and rock that devil. Amen. And God has also given you weapons, not just armory, but weapons to attack the devil. He has given you the sword of the Spirit, which is God's word. He has given you prayer and supplication, which is direct contact with the commander-in-chief. Amen. That's a weapon. When you're out in the battlefield, you got connected to the commander-in-chief, and he sees a war. He tells you where to go. He sees it all. He's guiding you through it. Amen. That's a weapon, amen? Yes, right. These weapons, this armor, is standard issue for any born-again believer, amen? That's right. As you put this stuff on, you will have even more weapons. This right here was the standard issue for every Christian soldier. The basic, right? But as you put this weapon on, as you put this armor on, he gives you other weapons that you don't even know about. You got to grow into these other weapons. This standard issue is given to you now. But as you put it on, and as you walk in it, then he gives you other kinds of weapons. He gives you the weapon of strategy. He gives you the weapon of technique. The weapon of being patient, waiting for the right time. He gives you patience about the weapon of understanding. He gives you the weapon of wisdom. All this is needed to exercise these basic weapons and armory. You put these weapons on, you got the thing, but if you don't know how to use it, or you're just gonna cut everybody, see, you have to have some technique, you have to have some strategy, you have to have wisdom to exercise these things, amen? The right timing, the perfect timing is everything. And as you put this on, then God gives you these other weapons to use these weapons, amen? He loads you up with all this stuff, and you have it right now with you. You have weapons that you don't even know how to use yet. But as you go in Christ, and you love him and serve him, and try to get close, and just do what he says, then you start getting understanding and knowledge on how to use these powerful tools you got right now today.
Amen.
Amen. They're already yours.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That's right. You must know them and know how to use them. You have to put on the whole armor of God, take up the weapons of warfare, and then get to rocking that enemy.
Amen?
Amen? Get to rocking them. Get behind me, Satan. Jesus has appeared to destroy your works in my life. Through his death and resurrection, he has rendered you powerless. He has rescued me from the kingdom of darkness.
Yes.
Amen?
Yes.
The devil doesn't want you to know all this stuff. But when the devil realizes that you know what you got and who you got, he'll get out.
Yes.
Amen?
Yes.
Depart from me, you cursed into everlasting fire. You have fallen from heaven like lightning. You will be judged and casted into the lake of fire. If you shall bring a charge against me, who can condemn me? Who shall separate me from the love of Jesus? I am more than a conqueror. Amen. I'm rocking him right now. I'm backing his butt up away from my stuff. Amen. Away from my family. Away from my children. Away from my grandchildren. Away from my friends. Amen. That's right, brothers and sisters. And in this church, I will fight for you. Every night you don't even know, but I battle for you in the spiritual realm.
Amen.
Sometimes for individual people, I remember, I start attacking the devil in secret. And most of the time, it's over all the church. I'm like, Lord, this is your church. I rebuke Satan from everybody under this umbrella of protection. Get out in the name of Jesus. Flee, you flee. Hallelujah. Can you get crazy? Say, flee, devil. I mean it. The devil knows if you want, devil, please go away. Devil, why are you giving me this trouble? Oh, devil, he's always on my back. Get out. Flee. Behind me. Get gone. Get into the lake of fire. Go bye-bye. Kick rocks. Hallelujah to Jesus. I'm going to rock them. Amen. Are you going to rock them? Or are you going to, oh, the devil's got me again. Oh my God. Get angry. Get mean. Get aggressive. Get violent with the devil. Amen. And the last verse I'll leave you with, say this to the devil: for I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other created thing shall be able to separate me from the love of Jesus. Bite! Take that, you devil!
Amen.
Hallelujah! Let us stand and give God glory.